on one of my recent videos, someone wanted to know if it's okay to put toothpaste on their pimples. Okay, so I decided just to create a video on that because if there's more than one person thinking that, they need to get this information. First thing to know is that toothpaste is formulated for your teeth, not for your skin. There are several ingredients in toothpaste that are not good for your skin. First one is sodium bicarbonate. That's baking soda. The pH is 9. It's very alkaline. Your skin is acidic. It's 5. So anytime you start to neutralize the acid on your surface of your skin, you're going to irritate it. Okay, so baking soda is not good to put on the outside of your body. Also, it's going to disrupt your natural flora or your bacteria of your skin. Next one, sodium lauryl sulfate. This compound actually can reduce plaque on your teeth. So when you put it on your skin, it's going to be too harsh. It's going to remove the oil layer. It's going to irritate the skin. It can actually even cause a rash that might look like acne. Next one is triclosan. Certain studies show that it may make your bacteria resistant to antibiotics. But number 4 is probably the most important thing to know. The fluoride in your toothpaste could create a condition called fluoroderma, which looks just like acne. There's a real interesting book that I read, and I actually did a video on it. I'll put a link for the book and the video down below. And so if you're rubbing fluoride on your skin or consuming tap water with fluoride, or taking a shower in water that has fluoride, it may worsen your skin. This is why I recommend using a fluoride filter for your shower. So if you want nice skin, don't use toothpaste on your acne. Instead, do these 4 things right here. Reduce your carbs. Get on a ketogenic diet. Why? Because carbs increase insulin, which then increases androgens, and too many androgens cause acne, as in PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Also, doing fasting, intermittent fasting, is probably one of the most powerful things you can do for your skin. Next one, probiotics, because if you don't have enough good bacteria in your gut, it actually can affect the bacteria on the surface of your skin and actually cause not only acne, but all sorts of issues with the skin. And last one is to avoid dairy, since dairy does have certain hormones like estrogen, and that can throw off your hormonal balance and produce acne as well. If people are estrogen dominant, they get cystic acne. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.